days they bring me joy.
But when the spotlight's on me, can't be ignored.
The life,
everybody wants
the life.
Infinity pools and high-tech cars, helicopters on speed one, I'm living so far.
The life, the life.
Everybody really wants it, but who really has it?
The life, the life.
Well, what's up, fellas? I ain't seen y'all since season one. What's going on?
I mean, you have seen us. You have seen me since season one, but you kind of act funny when I see y'all.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. Don't shade.
Well, obviously, the outfit wasn't cute enough that I didn't notice you.
Oh,
anyway.
So it's always about the outfit.
It's always about the outfit.
I'm just saying.
Yeah,
just
okay.
Saying.
Okay.
Well. Just like I just spoke to you like that.
No, we're hospital janitors, remember? Our outfits were hospital janitorial.
Okay.
Yeah.
So. Well, I mean, y'all have to admit, in season one, that was one of the not so good moments. But anyway.
Yeah, you gotta have fun with it though.
So what you expect out of from season two?
Well, I don't know what to expect out of y'all in season two because I no longer live in Atlanta. I'm a New Yorker, so it's on y'all.
He's a New Yorker.
And then he wondered why nobody likes him.
I know, that's why he probably left.
What can you expect from Josh from season two of The Life Atlanta? I can't speak for what Trinity's gonna do, but I know what I'm gonna do, and it's try not to go to jail.
Oh, well, what can you expect from season two of That Life Atlanta from Trinity? First of all, second of all, you can expect talent and beauty and poise and grace and, oh my God, just all types of different things. I'm not sure exactly what I'm gonna be, but whatever it is, it's gonna be fierce, as I always am. He can't take me. You really can't take me. As far as the people that I'm associated with, they are all badass people, just like me. Duh. Probably because I only associate myself with beautiful people. And De'Asia, well, yeah, well, y'all just watch out for De'Asia because her mouth is absolutely horrible. Couture's gonna be a little, you know, shaky, but he always keeps it cute. And Giovanni is gonna be the one that I'm gonna have to slap the shit out of. So if I end up going to jail, it's gonna be because of him. But I love him dearly. My crew is the best crew.
What to expect from Brittany this season? Well, you know, I'll be clothed this time, because last time the pilot was a little exposed, but I know you enjoyed it.
What's going on, Atlanta? It's Mario, it's your boy, better known as Mojo. What you can expect from me on season two of The Life is you can expect less of me, of course, because I have went through a change, but we'll talk about that a little later on. Also, since George is gone, I'm kind of glad about that too, because now that I can get the credit for my chicken wings, I can be less of a referee now because the shit starter is gone, and now we can concentrate on me being a star.
So what to expect from Johnny on season two of The Life Atlanta? Well, you're gonna get life from me, the baby, and not from the Golden Girls, who you've seen before. You're gonna get college life. You're gonna get the pastor's son. You're gonna get, you know, the wild child, but you know, that calm side, the real Johnny. You're just gonna get your life. You're just gonna get it.
Can you expect out of Alan for season two of The Life of Atlanta? It's gonna be a very juicy ride. And yes, I still own my own businesses. And yes, I still have bodyguards. Where's yours?
And just like Alan had his little bodyguard last season, I got one this season, and bigger and better. Alan, you better watch out this season.
And you know I'm still a boss, and ain't nobody about to take my spot. I'm still gonna be the diva of the show. I'm still gonna bring it.
What to expect from me, Danny, for season two of The Life of Atlanta? Someone's sexy, everybody loves chocolate. Someone's crazy, I'm not that cuckoo though, so don't get it twisted. And someone, you know, I have the little blonde moments every now and then, but still, don't get that twisted at all.
But wait, there's more. We'll be right back.
Atlanta, Georgia, Hotlanta, or simply Black Gay Mecca, it's become a very transient city, and boys are coming here by the drove every week. Some are rolling in on the Megabus, some are flying in on Spirit Airlines, and some are just simply piling up in the Buick and hitting the road down I-85. Some will last, some won't. Some will crash and burn, and some will become superstars. But it's all in the Life Atlanta.
Days they bring me joy, when the spotlight's on me can't be ignored.
The life,
everybody wants
the life.
Infinity pools and high-tech cars, helicopters on speed one, I'm living so far.
The life, the life.
Everybody really wants it, but who really has it?
The life, the life.
I apologize to the guys, so I said, you know what, I'm gonna invite them to my studio, you know, so we can really just talk, just me and the fellas, you know, plus a couple of the fellas said, you know, they rap and sing and stuff like that, so I thought it'd be a good idea to get them to come to the studio and just discuss this little issue in further detail.
So let me ask you a question. You've been with this dude for how long?
It was 8.5 months.
8.5 months. But y'all never physically was in the same state together.
No. I said he lived down here in Atlanta. That's when we got together. He had to move back to Baltimore for legal issues.
At 16, that?
You ain't give him no pussy or no dick, dog. You were not obligated to this man, period.
That's
I don't care how you put it. You did not.
You went way out there and did what you had to do with him because he was cheating on you.
People can be in a relationship and not fuck and do it all the time.
Right. So,
but in this situation,
not after
that wasn't working. Not when the other Johnny like, what's up, babe?
No, you don't know he was like that.
But we going by
the Virginia, just like I live in
it's just about statistics. So if I was 16 years old and me and him was talking and stuff like that, and we're not having sex, what the fuck? You at your prime peak. You want to have sex.
Right. But my
so
thing is,
if you know I'm not having sex with him, I'm gonna get from somebody. Right. I mean, I'm just being real.
Okay, but that's
that. And when you're at that age,
but
and you know what you want, he's not wrong
sex
for that.
But you have to realize,
especially if you don't want to have sex with him.
Cause y'all coming at me like y'all need to chill. So
I'm
agreeing with what you're saying.
You put it out there, so we just let you know.
So you were right in the frame when I said it.
We're not criticizing about your relationship, honey. We just let you know. We're not criticizing you about your relationship. We just letting you know how relationships work, what you can expect and what you can't expect.
So I'm sitting here in the midst of all of these different age groups, if you add them all up, over 200 years of people. And, you know, I'm minding my business. And then it comes to relationships, and we start talking about sex and how basically if you're not having sex, that you're not gonna have a good relationship, and that's why people leave their boyfriend. And what type of sense does that make? I need to have sex in order to keep a relationship. Well, if you want to have sex, you don't need a relationship if you're focused on that. How about that?
The way that you think is, that's why I say you're probably the same person.
It's just different.
No, we're not.
Yes, y'all are.
No, we're not. No, we are not. Don't even go there. We are not the same person, bitch. I was not like that at 20 years old, so let's not even go there.
You and Al are the same person now.
No, we are not the same person now, then, before, or after, or none of that bullshit. Don't even go there.
But see, this is why. This is why y'all are the same person, because nobody can tell you different from the
No, that is wrong. See, that is wrong. No, because you can't even say that. You can't even say that because you haven't even been around me 24 hours around the day.
I'm
no.
About
no. You talking about this. You talking about this right here.
Oh, no, this conversation right here.
But see, that's why I have to stop you at, because we are not the same person, because I am very open-minded. When people tell me something, I am very open-minded and I am very receptive to what they tell me.
But that's contradicting right. because you're not even accepting what I'm saying right now.
Because you're trying to compare me to a 20-year-old.
I'm not comparing you. I'm just saying that you guys have a similar mindset.
No, we don't have a similar mindset. We don't. No, we don't.
No, you're not listening. The reason why I said, hear me out. Y'all both just said, when he just said the same thing, you wouldn't date anybody. That's why he just said that he wanted to say sorry, because you said you wouldn't date a porn star, and you said your beliefs, and then when he finally heard it, he said, hold on.
No, wait, let me correct you first. Let me correct you. No, bitch, let me correct you. Because I first said I would date a porn star.
No, that's
I did say I would date a porn star, and I told y'all all that.
Yeah.
I told you I would not discriminate against anybody whatsoever. The only thing that changed my mind is what came out of his mouth that made me feel like I could not trust him. So if I can't trust you, then I probably can't trust the next motherfucker, because if you out there shaking your ass for a dollar or two, you might be sucking dick for $10 in the back corner and stuff like that and telling me you love me, but you might be letting somebody fuck you in the ass and every damn thing else. Because you got somebody paying your bills and shit.
So Alan invited me and the rest of the crew to the studio, his studio, to, you know, just talk a little bit and play around in the booth and, you know, see what hidden talents everybody had. And of course, I was not missing it, because the last time I missed some shit, they almost did WWE SmackDown at Joe's, and I almost missed that. And I was gonna have a real attitude had I missed anything else. So I made sure I was there for this shit, because I didn't know what was gonna pop off and if Johnny was gonna be there and Alan was gonna be there. I know it was gonna be some good TV, so I needed to make sure I was present in that motherfucker, because I didn't know what was gonna happen.
Y'all still the same motherfucking person, no matter how y'all wanna put it, and y'all are going to be great friends after this. Already feel it, because y'all have so much alike. You're just talking at each other. You're looking at a fucking mirror. You're looking
no,
at
bitch,
yourself.
No, bitch. No, he's not.
And that's nothing
no,
to look
no,
on.
No,
that's
bitch, no. No, no, shit. No, bitch, no.
Well, his studio.
No. I ain't saying it's bad, but no, that he ain't looking in no fucking mirror, though.
Yes, he is.
No, he is not. Bitch, that's your feelings is wrong, bitch. You on a whole other planet, bitch.
No,
yes, you are. You on a whole other cosmo planet, bitch. You are.
This is brown.
No. Okay, you need to leave that shit alone, then. You need to leave that alone, because we are not a mirror image person at all. He has his own mind. He has his own individuality. It's separate from mine. It's completely different. Our views might be similar, personality-wise different. Completely. Way completely.
Everybody's an individual.
Can we go in here and do this thing? This conversation is really just...
What were you y'all, doing, simple-minded ass people?
You don't know what you're talking about, bitch. You don't know what you're talking about at all.
You went to Alan's studio, and of course, you know, you get a studio, you get a group of people, everybody's saying like, oh yeah, I can sing, I can do this, da 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 da. So everybody went into the booth. Now, all of us know that Danny is the quietest person. Danny really doesn't say anything, Danny really doesn't come around, but you know, he says he has to work. But when Danny got in the booth, that was a whole different person.
I'm surprised, shit.
You said it was a rock game.
So it was time for everybody to get in the booth and do their little singing thing. Of course, me, I'm silly as hell, so I'm thinking, oh, this is gonna be hilarious. These people ain't gonna have no talent. They gonna go in here playing around, yada, yada, yada. We using up this man's studio time, wasting his time and shit. And I'm sure Alan was thinking somebody else was gonna be stupid too and sound dumb, so he could throw it up in their face and say, girl, you ain't got no talent. You know how he do. But to my surprise, we all fucked it up. First of all, Danny went in there, spitting mad lyrics. Like, never would have thought that would have came out of his mouth. He always quiet shit. I just learned his name. I barely knew who he was. But when he got behind that mic, beast, total beast. Johnny has an absolutely beautiful voice.
I don't wanna burn you with me. Oh, I love you, I love you, I love you. I don't wanna burn you with me.
favor, love.
Damn!
Do it again?
No, bitch, get out the booth. I don't want to hear you sing no more, bitch. All y'all can sing. I can't sing shit, goddamn. Get out! Get out! Goddamn it. Hell, nothing, goddamn. You did enough, goddamn it.
I was having fun.
I know you was, bitch. Get out!
That booth is a dicker. I know. You might do it over for every year.
So walking in the studio, I'm just like, first time ever, I'm pretty much a little scared. But you know, I watch a lot of Empire, so I'm like, okay, maybe it's gonna be like Empire. But then you got smoke everywhere, you got people just all standing around, you got your real hood people, and I'm like, oh shit, you know, I'm a little scared because my sexuality, and I'm up in here with all these people, and I'm like, okay, what if any damn thing pop out? So I had to make sure I know what each exit was so I can get the hell up out of there. Then you had Trinity comes in, well, hold on, let me take that back. You had Josh come in, and he does one of his songs that he did from, I guess, when he was on tour at RuPaul's Drag Race, you know. No shade or anything, but he goes in, he does one of his original songs, which was kind of like a pop song, and it's something that I can hear in like a nice techno club or something like that, but it was really good.
Nothing he just said at all.
What about that?
Everybody did really well. Brodney even sang with his Aretha Franklin voice. You know, as Alan would say, he needs some development. But he did pretty well. I think everybody kind of got out of the box a little bit, and I liked it.
Oh, he's singing the same thing?
Yeah.
Aw. That's cute.
Talk
to me
real quick. That other beat that I played.
Shit.
Do you
want to
do something today?
My
fucking
lighter.
Yo,
you can start.
Just start it from like. Get out. It starts immediately though.
Open your mouth.
Okay.
Yeah, stop singing out of your nose. Stop singing out of your, stop being nervous. Stop singing out of your nose.
Just give me that chorus though.
I got you. Just open your mouth and sing to the person.
Open it, bitch.
Take it all in, take it all in.
Go in there, Trinity, so he can sing to you.
Go in there, babe. I don't wanna blow.
Johnny can sing, but just like Alan was telling me, you know, with some vocal lessons, I think Johnny could get vocal lessons too. But then I really don't know, like, how... I didn't know how to take Alan's critique because I haven't seen any of his artists publish anything. So I just kind of took it with a grain of salt.
You can rap, you can sing.
I can sing.
I'm decisive still.
Nice
he got a nice voice.
I have a nice voice, but see, I don't.
He's singing out of his nose.
Yeah, I don't.
You want to ask me that?
Vocal lessons.
Yeah, right. I don't sing.
But he has a nice voice. Vocal lessons would be perfect. You have a nice voice, though.
Do you even want to, like?
No.
Okay, that's why.
That's why.
If you actually wanted to, you could do a lot.
You could do a lot with your voice. So. I think you should try it. And you, yeah, okay, well, really you did a nice one on your track.
I like your Australian beat.
Your Australian beat.
Thank you.
And it's a market for that. So, yeah, you come here, we can do some things together.
Oh, I can come back up here. I can buy some time.
Yeah, you gotta get some vocal lessons first.
Well, I don't know. Nah. You don't?
I need them too. Huh? I need them too. I definitely need them too.
Bitch, that's why you look up vocal coaches. Get a vocal coach.
I'm a vocal coach. I don't coach a damn thing.
Yeah,
I can't, though. But I think he would be a beast if he laid the track down.
Yeah,
you got a perfect voice. You really do.
All that throat and neck and chest.
You sound like Luther.
You always saying that, bitch, because you like him. That's the only reason why you're saying that.
You was waiting to say that, wasn't you?
Bitch, we all waiting to say it. Ain't nothing new.
Okay. That's fine.
Okay, that's why he ain't said nothing.
That's fine.
Yeah. Hello. How are you?
I need a drink.
You've been having a drink. You don't need no more to drink. I'm like, okay.
All right.
Bye.
Nice. I'm glad you invited us over here.
Uh-huh.
Tell him to hurry up and finish her music.
Bye-bye. This bitch been on the phone the whole time.
That's business over there.
If y'all see Bam, you know.
All right, sure.
I'll tell him you got some choice words.
Yeah, I got some very choice words. Because he could have called us back and said, I'm really...
I don't know if he probably thought I was beautiful. I mean, of all people, Adam was the one that kept saying how beautiful I was. Like, oh my God, you're so beautiful.
That you are.
Well, thank you. Yeah, Adam was the one who was like, oh, you're so beautiful. I'm like, thank you. He didn't really say much of anything. I just asked him, would he do the shoot with me? And he said yes. That was about it. I was 14 and I'm going to be 25, and I still have not really got a chance to be Josh.
So you've been doing this for a decade.
Oh my God. That's awful. It really is, yeah.
Goodness.
Yeah. So I want to just be a guy. Because I will forever always be identified as straight.
Right.
Even 20 years from now, I can be fine as shit, muzzled out of my mind like I want to be.
Right.
And I'm still going to be identified as, oh, that's the person who's on RuPaul's Drag Race. Oh, that's Trippy. She performed. She was fierce. She. That's right. She. That's always going to be like that label. And it really, really bothers me. It really bothers me.
What do you think?
I can separate people, so why can't people separate me?
And do you think you allow people to like know who Josh is? Do you think you put a lot of effort into introducing everybody to Josh?
I think I do, but I think it's not fair for me to answer that because I can't speak for somebody else.
Right.
A person may look at me and I may think I'm giving them as much as who I really am as possible, but they may still only see Trinity, which is what I was telling people. The first impression meeting you, you know, I don't want to meet a guy that I'm interested in my first time in drag. That's why I won't flirt or flirt back with people when I'm a girl, because I don't feel like you're getting to know who I am.
Right.
You have a fascination with the person that you see in front of you.
Right.
And first impressions are lasting in my eyes. So. And most of the time, when I'm out, or in a situation I'm normally in drag, and I tend to get in on more that way.
Really?
Yeah. And not even, and I'm not gonna say that, but like, you know, trade or whatever.
Right.
A lot of butch queens will give me more, oh my God, you're so pretty, you're so talented, I love you, wanna hug and be up under you all night. They'll rather do that when you're a girl, but they will not, they don't see shit when I'm a boy. You just blend it. Which is why I feel like that's why a lot of film queens or entertainers that our film queens now became girls. Because they accepted like and molded more as a girl. And it's very easy to get manipulated when you want to be loved, when you want somebody to like you, and you want to be in this industry and be accepted to just go get breasts and become a girl.
And you
but then you're stuck. You know what I'm saying? You don't, you're literally stuck in this box.
And you never thought about doing that.
No. No.
So it's always just been about independence.
Yeah, I've had those thoughts where I'm like, damn, people appreciate me more when I have no hair than they do as who I really am.
Right.
So I'm like, well, maybe that's the life I should live. I mean, it runs across, I think, any entertainer's mind, because you'd be damned as you'd be like, what the fuck? What am I doing any different? This person is a made-up character.
Right.
If I never put a wig on again, you'll never see me. So why is that so important that you like this character I made up versus who I am? And it's just a constant struggle trying to figure it out.